So some more expressions we will see now. So let us make a blank slide here, new slide. So we have A star B slash, okay, 1 plus 2 brackets into 7. Right, starting with simple expressions. So now you have a new term, because now you are encountering the brackets also. So 1 plus 2 star 7. So what happens here is, since we have the brackets, we have to take a higher priority for the brackets, right? All the brackets make not much of a difference. Let me just write the priority once again. So 5 highest priority, 4 3 2 and 1. Okay, so we have a stack and we have an expression which is nothing but a postfix expression. Stack initially is empty. So what happens here is we encounter these braces, right? So brackets, whenever you encounter, because these are not numbers, we just put into the stack as it is. So remember, for brackets there is no priority, right? There is no priority. Priority is only for this. So now we are encountering 1, so 1 will be here in the postfix expression. Then we encounter plus, right? So plus we directly push onto the stack, right? As I said, brackets have no priority, so you need not check whether bracket is higher than plus or anything like that. Nothing to be done. Then I come across 2, right? So the expression is again 2. The only rule with bracket is whenever you see a closing bracket, right? This is a closing bracket. That too, closing C bracket. So then you pop everything till you see a opening curly bracket, right? Till you see this, irrespective of priority, right? So what happens with bracket is, see, you put the opening bracket here, then plus came, and now this particular guy came, the closing one. So what you do, pop all till the opening is encountered, right? So what you do, and you ignore the brackets. So you don't write the brackets in the expression. So what will happen? You ignore the brackets. One will, plus will pop, plus will come here. You will keep on popping till the opening round bracket. So you will pop till here and then stop. In this case, the stack actually gets empty. Right, so you have reached this expression and now you will have star. So what happens? You place a star here and then you will have 7. So expression ends, right? Expression end, what we do? We pop everything from stack to make it empty, right? So this is how you get the expression. Also, if you solve this kind of equation, right, always it is better to do a mental calculation just to verify. Right, so 1 plus 2, right? So this is A plus B and it is bracket, so this will become 1 2 plus star 7. Assume it to be y into 7, so A into B becomes y 7 star. What was y? Y is 1 2 plus and 7 star, right? So what happens? See, this is 1 plus 2 and this, right? So for brackets, the rule is, okay, let us do a simple example using brackets. Let us say the expression is 1 plus 2, right? So this is our stack and this is our expression. So we know the answer is 1 plus 2, right? So when you encounter this, you push this on the stack, right? When you encounter 1, 1 becomes the part of expression. Then you have plus, so you don't see any priority because there was a bracket here. Then you come across 2, 2 is in the expression. Now you come across closing curly bracket. So whenever you come across closing round bracket, pop everything till you encounter an opening round bracket. So if you see a closing curly bracket, pop everything till you get an opening curly bracket, right? Irrespective of the expressions, or irrespective of the operators in the stack. So what happens? The moment, see, you don't push this, so I'm writing in a dotted form. The moment you push the closing curly bracket, you don't push actually, you pop everything. So one is popped and till the opening round bracket, right? So this will get popped, this will get popped. So what happens? The stack is empty, the expression is end. So this is how you get the postfix notation. So right now we got two rules. So on stack, this is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So asterisk can sit over any of these stack top elements. This can sit over any of these stack top elements, but you cannot have anything over higher precedence, higher or equal precedence, right? So for example, let us try this expression, 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5, right? So what will be the expression? Let us assume this to be the first expression. Now you may say that star and star both have equal priorities. So what will be evaluated first? First we go from left hand side. So here we see the left hand to right hand. So since we do from LHS to the right hand side, we will first solve 3 into 4, right? So 3 into 4, the postfix will become 3, 4, star. Asterisk 5, for simplicity, assume this as y. Y into 5, what will be the expression? Y, 5, star. Right? What is y? 3, 4, star and 5, star. Right? I usually substitute y so that it is easier to comprehend. I will try to break every equation in the form of a plus b or a star b, something like that. Okay? So now let us try to solve again. So what happens? 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5. Our operator order was this plus and minus. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is our stack. Stack can only contain this one. Okay, this is plus. And this is postfix expression. So let us read from left to right. So first is 3. 3 will come here. Stack is here. Then you come across star. Stack is empty. Nothing to do. Just push on the stack. Then you encounter 4. 4 I will keep in the expression because in stack only the operators go. And now see what I come. I come across star again. What is the stack top? It is star. So both are stars. Right? So now what happens? See, the rule is only a higher priority can sit on top. Only a higher priority can sit on top. Even if there are equal priority or lower, even if there are equal priority, right, we have to pop it off, right? So what happens? You have to keep popping all the operators from the stack. Once again, you have to pop all the elements from the stack till you get something which is lower in priority. Something which is lower in priority, right? Now what happens? The stack has only one element, which is star, right? Once the star is popped out, so what happened when the star is popped out? It will come here and the stack is empty. So now since the stack is empty, now we will push this star onto the stack, right? So this is not there at all, right? So our stack has only one element, which is asterisk. Let us redraw the stack. Now we have only one star. This star was at this particular position. Now we come across expression 5. I write 5 here. End of string, right? So what we do? We will pop everything, right? So this is the postfix expression. The thing to note here is that you cannot have even equal precedence operator one above the other. The operators below the stack top has to be always lower, not even equal or higher. They cannot be, right? So if you encounter something which is equal or higher, keep popping till you get a lower priority. So for example, if you are trying to keep an exponent, right? So exponent is the highest operator. So definitely everything from the stack will be popped once you encounter this exponent operator. Let us do again one more expression. So let me erase everything on the screen. Okay, A star B slash C. Okay. A star B slash C, you know this is the operator precedence, right? We start the expression from left hand side. This is the stack and this is the expression. So what happens with an expression? First A comes, I just keep here A, and let me 5 4 3 2 1. Now I see an asterisk coming, right? So I keep the asterisk because stack top is empty, so everything is fine. Then I come across B. B will be a part of expression. And now see, I come across slash. Where is slash? Slash or the division operator is here. Only a higher precedence operator can be placed. Equal or lower, if there, then you have to keep popping, right? So the moment you see, so basically asterisk can sit over slash, but slash cannot sit over asterisk because 3 is less than 4, 3 cannot sit over 4, right? Iska precedence kya hai? Star has a precedence of 4. 3 has a precedence here, so 3 cannot be placed here. So what we have to do? We have to keep popping till lower priority element is encountered, right? So we are popping star now. Right, so star is popped. Okay, once the star is popped, so what will happen? Once the star is popped, I will keep slash here. And now I see the expression as C. Okay. And now C is the end of string. End of string. So what do we do at the end of string? We pop everything. So it will become A, B star, C and slash. Okay. That is how. And even if you go by our normal trick, A into B slash C, this is the operator precedence. So multiplication has to be done before. So what is A star B expression? This will be A, B star. And the rest expression remains the same. For AB star, I will assume this to be Y, Y slash C. And now this we know, Y slash C, the postfix is this. Now we substitute Y with AB star, C slash. This expression and this expression both are same, right? So you can see it is not difficult. It is just requiring some amount of practice. If the exams are conducted, let's hope for the best. So in exam, you will not be asked to show directly what is the postfix expression. You will be asked to show in this stepwise manner how are we able to calculate it. Okay. Okay. So for this expression, I have made an animation that will make it clear. So we have such a huge amount of brackets. We have plus, asterisk and this. Okay, so first we encounter, just see the rectangle, but just see the triangle here. Keep an eye on this. This will point to the current element that is being read. So we have the stack and we have the output. So once we see an opening round bracket, just push on to the stack. Again a round bracket, push on the stack. Again a round bracket, the third one, push on the stack. Then you have A. Of course, A is not an operator. So A will be go in the output. Ignore the square bracket in the output, that is just to hold the expression, right? So that square bracket in the output means nothing. Even if it is, that is ignored, it's okay. Now plus, right? Plus comes here. Plus will go into the stack. As I said, opening closing brackets have no priority. Once you see a closing bracket, pop everything till you encounter its equivalent opening bracket. Now B comes, B will go in the expression, right? Now you see our stack has this, this, this and plus. And now you will encounter this thing. The moment this comes, you pop everything till its equivalent opening curly bracket is encountered, right? Because one closing bracket has come, so we will pop till only one opening curly bracket, opening round bracket, not all, right? Because for one closing pair, we have to search its equivalent opening pair. And we will pop everything. So you will see this output will become this, and eventually this will be gone. See, this is gone. So two brackets will be there and AB plus. Now what happens? Stack is having only two opening brackets. Now I encounter star, I will just push on the star. Again I encounter a bracket, I will just push on the stack. As I said, brackets have no priority. They are just to be making sure regarding pop operations. Now we come across C, that will go into the output. And now you have minus, right? Minus goes onto the stack. Now you may see that minus has a lower priority than this, right? We said this is the expression that we studied, right? Now since star is already on the stack, how did we allow minus to be a part of stack? The answer is we only look at the stack top. We don't see the entire stack. Remember one thing, we only see the stack top. So the stack top before entering minus was opening round bracket. And as I said, brackets have no priority. That is zero priority, right? So minus can be easily placed because minus has one priority, right? I hope it makes less sense. Now again, E comes, E will go here, right? Now you see, you will see a closing bracket, right? You can see this is the closing bracket. So once you see a closing bracket, pop everything. So this will pop and till its equivalent opening bracket is encountered, right? So minus will come here. See, minus comes here and we have opening bracket and star. Next, we again have a closing. So we have a closing parenthesis. So what will happen? This we don't push onto the stack. This star will come here and this will go. So the stack will only contain one bracket. See, the stack will contain only one bracket. Now you have slash, slash comes here. We have another opening bracket, goes onto the stack. Then we have F, we are here. Then we come across plus. Again, the stack top is opening bracket. So you directly will push one here. See, one is here. G comes, G goes onto the stack. Then we have round bracket. So what will happen? This will be popped out. This will go here. And this expression will go. Right? Just see, this goes. Again, round bracket and the stack is empty. Stack is empty, the string ends, so the output is the expression, right? I hope it makes sense, right? Let us look at once again what happens here. See, this expression was relatively very simple, I would still say, right? Because the parentheses were really well formed, okay? So let us do one thing. So A plus B, asterisk C minus E. Right, and this has a big bracket here, division F plus G, and this is the whole bracket. So see, A plus B, what it will become? AB plus in this bracket multiplied by C minus E will become C minus E. This is the bracket, and then this whole expression divided by FG plus. Let us assume AB plus to be, let's say, not x, let us say this is p into q slash, let us say this is r. What was our order? This, this, plus and minus. So what happens? P into q, what it will become? PQ asterisk divided by R. Let us assume this to be S. So S by R will be equal to SR slash, right? SR slash. Now what was S? S was PQ star R slash. What was P? P was AB plus. What was Q? Q was CE minus. And what was R? This was FG plus and star. Right? So this is how it is usually better to compute the answer first and then try to solve it, just to verify whether your answers are coming right or not. So this again is the expression. Right? So remember, see, AB plus was there, CE minus was there, FG plus, this asterisk was in between, and this was at the last. Right, so this was all about infix to postfix. And now you will ask one simple question, sir, if given a postfix expression, how do you solve it? Right? So let us do one thing. We go back to our slide. Erase all the ink. So let us just take very simple expression. 2 plus 3 plus 5. Right? So what will happen in the stack? So first expression goes here, I make it 2, then plus is encountered, plus comes here, then I encounter 3, plus, same priority cannot be there, so plus is here, this is erased, and now this plus will go into the stack, and finally 5, and finally expression ends, so this plus is here, right? Even by our steady approach or by our direct method, 2 plus 3 will become 2, 3 plus and plus 5. Assume this to be y, y plus 5, which is y 5 plus. What was y? 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus. Right? This is the expression. So now let's say, given this expression, how do you evaluate it? Right? So we are given, say, this is the postfix expression. How do you evaluate? Now remember one thing, whenever we do such things, we usually use the operator between two things. So like A plus B. So plus will be added for A and B. So for this we again use a stack. Right? So we read the expression from left to right. So 2, push into the stack. 3, again push into the stack. Now plus comes. So whenever an operator comes, remember this thing. Whenever an operator comes, pop two elements, the stack, two elements from the stack, use that operator and push back the result again. So operator has come, so pop two elements, use the operator and push the answer. So what happens, this is our stack, so we pop two elements. What we will pop? 3 and 2. Use the operator. What was the operator? The operator was plus. 3 plus 2. What is the answer? 5. And then push the answer. Now since you had popped this, stack became empty. So now what is in the stack? It is 5. Now what happens? 5 comes. 5 again you push on the stack. And then plus comes. So whenever an operator comes, pop two elements. So I pop this 5 and I pop this 5. Use the operation. What was the operation? Plus. What is the answer? That is 10. So I push back 10. String ends, pop everything from the stack, and that is the answer. So 10 is the answer. I know I went a bit fast through this example. Once again, let me do it. Okay. So let us take something 2 into 3 plus 5. Okay. So what happens here? So now we know 2, 3 star plus 5, y plus 5, y 5 plus, 2, 3 star 5 plus, right? This is our postfix. And by school mathematics we know 2 into 3 is 6 plus 5, the answer should be 11. Now let us see how magically this expression will calculate. Okay? So now we say we have an empty stack. Okay, let me try to draw a stack-wise example. So initially 2 is there in the stack. Then 3 comes. We again push to the stack. Now I encounter star. So whenever you encounter this, pop 2 elements, perform operation and push the result. So when I pop 2 elements, first element popped is 3. So the stack will remain here as 2. So element number 1. And when I pop this, element number 2 is 2. And what was the operation? What was the operator? Operator was star. So what I will do? 3 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 6. And push this back into the stack. So whenever an operator is coming, pop 2 elements, because an operator will work between 2 elements. Pop 2 elements, perform the operation and push back the result. This is important. So you have to push back 6. Right? Now what happens? You come across 5. So you push into the stack 6, 5. Finally you come across plus. So what happens? Pop 2 elements. So element 1 will be 5, element 2 will be 6. And operator was plus. 5 plus 6 is 11. Right? When you pop, this stack become empty and push 11 into the stack. Right? Once you have pushed 11 into the stack, the string is empty. So this 11 pop up from the stack and this is your answer. Okay, again you will say, why do you do all these stuff? Right? Now let us take an expression. 2 plus 3 star 5. Okay, so we know what will be the equivalent postfix. 2 3 plus multiplied by 5. So 2 3 plus and 5 asterisk. This is the postfix. What is the answer? 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 into 5 is equal to 25. Now let us see, the postfix expression does not have any parentheses. Okay. Now let us see how this postfix actually help us. Let us now evaluate this expression. Okay, so we have 2 on the stack, 3 on the stack. Whenever the plus is encountered, pop 2 element. So e1 equal to 3, element 2 equal to this. So 2 plus 3 is 5 and push back 5 onto the stack. What I encountered is 5. I encounter 5, I put here and then asterisk. So 5 into 5 is again 25. String is ending here. So the answer is 25. And now let us take the other example. 2 plus 3 into 5. Right? 3 into 5 is 15 plus 2. This is 17. So what will be the expression here? Because in this, asterisk has the higher priority. So we do it 2 plus 3 5 asterisk and then we make it 2 3 5 asterisk plus, right? Assuming this was y. So it becomes 2y plus and this is the expression. Now let us take stack. 2 3 5 and now you encounter an asterisk. So what we will do? We will pop 2 elements from the stack. So e1 will be 5. Right, 2 elements mean top 2 elements from the stack, because stack works only on the top. Element 2 is 3. What was the operator? A star. So you do the perform 5 multiplied by 3, which is equal to 15. And push the result onto the stack to make it more neat, because this was popped. 2 was already there. 15 was the result. What was the operator now? Plus. So what happens? 2 elements to be popped. E1 is 15, E2 is 2, operator is plus. 15 plus 2 is 17 and I push 17 into the stack. So now you see both the postfix expression both the postfix expression did not have brackets. okay, it did not have brackets, and finally I could solve the expression even without the need of brackets, right? So you realized how postfix expressions are very useful for solving mathematical expression. Brackets are for humans like us, right? So in both the postfix expression there was no bracket, still the final answer was the same that we had for the infix expression with brackets, right? So this is how you use stacks for doing infix to postfix, and that ends for today's lecture.